we will be performing eccentric neural grooving for shoulder internal rotation from the sideline base position. So you progress from your pills and rails, which really allows us to open up more range into our pals and rails, which is our pass range holds, pass range liftoffs, hovers, and ridge rotations. And now we are in our eccentric neural grooving. So we're gonna be creating tension, so kind of like our pails contraction, but then we will be lengthening into more internal rotation under tension or under load. So this is further along the line in terms of overall complexity, and it's really what we wanna make sure we're doing it correctly. We're gonna make sure we're not compensating through any areas of the body so we get the most out of it, while we also maintain maximum shoulder health. So to set the position up, you're gonna do the same thing as your sideline internal rotation pails and rails. So if you have a foam roller, if you have a yoga block, if you have a pillow, something that you can just relax your head onto, I will stack my shoulders. So I'll have my target arm just directly under my left arm, or under my left shoulder. I'll have my knees at about 90 degrees. I can have them straight, I can have them bent, or I can pull them down about 45 degrees, and then I wanna think, stick the butt back, so that as I contract down here, I have space to move into, right? I wanna make sure my body's not getting in the way, make sure my chest isn't in the way. So I'm sticking my butt out, giving myself this area here that I can move into on the eccentric, right? So I'm gonna rest my head, make sure I have good space between my headrest and my shoulder, make sure I'm not shrugging up into my ear. So I'm pulling that shoulder blade down, making sure this backside of my shoulder stays on the floor. I can do it from a 90 degree position. I can really do it through any of these zones here. So I can be slightly above, right out from the shoulder, or we'll come right just below. That's where we're gonna perform this one from here. I'm gonna take top side hand to my bottom side wrist. I'm gonna think top side presses down at about a 10 out of 10, bottom side presses up at a 9 out of 10. So it's an isometric contraction to begin, right? So hand and wrist press into one another, and then from there, top hand starts to win. So I'm pressing down, and that's where the eccentric component comes in, where now I'm lengthening that shoulder tissue while I'm still trying to load it. Find the bottom of my stretch position there, come right back up. Reset that tension, take a breath in, contract, press together, and then I slowly lower. I think under about a 5 count is a great place to start. Find the bottom of that position, relax, come right back up. So we're just doing the eccentric component here, right? So we're just doing the lengthening component. Take a breath in, contract together, top hand wins, and now I come down, find my bottom position, relax, come right back up. So there's a side lying shoulder internal rotation, eccentric neural grooming.